Welcome to this introductory video to concepts of programming languages. In this video, I will explain to you the course organization. So that consists of the mode of instruction, the associated literature to this course, the lecture agenda, the assessment method, and the assessments contain both group assessments and an individual assessment, and finally the contact details. So the mode of instruction for this course consists of two parts. One part is online and is a self-study component. This means that it is expected that you watch the lecture videos. These take about 2 up to maximum 3 hours a week. And that you will study the literature yourself. For more detail, you can see the Brightspace page where both the links to the lecture videos are provided and an overview of the literature. We also have physical meetings. These physical meetings take place at the Snellius or Huygens building. There are 2 hours of exercise classes. These focus mostly on the theoretical aspects of the course. And you can bring a pencil and paper, that's sufficient. You can make notes during the exercise classes. And these are mostly interactive, so we will work together on example problems. Then after the exercise classes, there are the practical sessions, the practical labs. And in the practical labs, you will be working mostly on group work and involving programming exercises. So for the location of the exercise classes and the practical labs, you can see this URL. I'll also put more information about the location on Brightspace. The literature of this course will be quite free. You are free to choose which book you want to dive into. On Brightspace, there will be a selection of books. You can then select a book that fits your interest the most. Some of the books are more theoretical or mathematical in nature. So if you are interested in learning more about that, I certainly recommend choosing those books. Other books are more practical. And for instance, focus more on techniques or concepts involved in the programming context. In any case, if you have questions about, for instance, certain concepts that are introduced in these books, it's always a good idea to discuss these with your fellow students. Moreover, if you have any questions, you cannot figure it out with your fellow students, it is always possible to send me an email in which you can then ask for clarification or for more explanation or maybe pointers to different sources. It is important, because we don't use a standard reference for this course, that you take note of all the sources that you have looked at during this course. And at the end, there is an individual assignment, a critical literature review, in which you will note down all the sources you have used and what you think are the best sources or what you think are maybe confusing sources or sources where the information is presented wrongly. So take note of everything that you look at, because this then certainly helps you with writing the critical literature review. So reading the literature is self-study. You can, if you put around 2 to 3 hours reading time a week for this course, that is probably a good amount. And you can steer what you want to read more about based on your interests. Then there are the lectures, and the lectures are thematically grouped together. And so in each week we will cover one of these themes. So the lecture videos are already published online, so you could already have a look at that. And then for each of the dates in the left column, we will have an exercise class. And after the exercise class, we have practical labs. In the exercise class, the topics that were introduced during the video lectures of that week are explained in more detail by the means of doing exercises. Then there are the practical labs, and in and during the practical labs, you can work in groups finishing programming assignments. As you can see over here in the third column, the first practical lab consists of forming groups, and I'll explain later more about that. And each of the assignments will be published at a certain date. So it is also the case that the deadline for the first assignment will be 12 October, and the deadline for the second assignment will be 9 November, and the deadline for the third assignment will be 7 December. Okay. Then the assessment method of this course. So the assessment consists of two parts. There is an examination of teamwork. You will work in a group of a maximum of 3 people. During this first lab, you should form a group and register your group. And note, it is not possible to switch groups during the course. So once you have registered your group, you will stay in that group for the remainder of the course. There are 3 mandatory assignments. So your group should complete these 3 assignments. But there are moreover 2 bonus assignments. So whenever you're having extra time and you want to dive more into exercising your programming skills, you can, together with your group, complete the 2 bonus assignments. Furthermore, there is an individual examination. The individual examination consists of 2 parts. One part is an individual assignment, which is the critical literature review. You write this yourself. And finally, there is a written exam. And the written exam will contain questions that are similar to the questions that we treat during the exercise classes. So if you want to prepare for the written exam, it is a good idea to attend all the exercise classes to get an idea of what will also be questions asked during the written exam. The grade for this course is calculated as follows. You take the average of the assignments, of the mandatory assignments, I should say. So those are the 3 mandatory assignments that you make as a group. Plus your individual assignments grade, and then averaging it. The bonus assignment each allow you to get an additional point on the category, on this category of the calculation. So if you successfully complete 1 bonus assignment, you get an additional point for your assignments. If you complete 2 bonus assignments successfully, you get 2 points extra. So that is also a component which is the written exam, counting for the other half. And this is based entirely on what you do during the written exam, 30 January. to pass the course, it is necessary to have, for both parts, at least a 5.5. The group assignments are timely announced, and here you get an ID of what the topics of these assignments are. So the assignments 1, 2, and 3 are mandatory. So with your group that you have formed during the first lab, you can work on these assignments, and the deadlines are over here. What I already explained, can continue working on assignment 4 and 5, but these are counting as bonus points. Also, 4 and 5 are completed with your group. You can choose for these assignments in which programming language you would like to write down your programs. So we split up all the students into two classes, class 1 and class 2. Class 1 makes use of the programming language C or C++, and class 2 makes use of the JavaScript programming language. Class 1 will be assisted by the teaching assistants Wessel and Rens, and class 2 will be assisted by David. Once you register your group in one of these classes, it is also not possible to switch. So once you have chosen a programming language, you're stuck to it for the rest of the course. So during this forming session, so the first practical session, you might want to ask around what is the best language for your group to complete the assignments in, and the teaching assistants can help you answering that question. So these are the group assignments. Then there is also the individual assignment, which consists of this critical literature review. As I already mentioned, it is important to keep track of all the sources you have accessed during the course. This includes books, articles, but also web resources. To give you an idea of what is expected, the submission format for this individual assignment is to be written in LaTeX, which makes use of the standard article layout, and you have your submission has at least 4 pages, but can go up to 10 pages to give you an idea how much writing work this is. But more details about this individual assignments will follow soon. At least the deadline is known. It is before the end of the year, 30 December. If you have any questions or any suggestions, if there is anything that you would like to discuss, you can always contact me at the following email address. For questions about grades or assignments, you can ask Yinting Bian. She is supervising the lab sessions, and these are the contact details of the teaching assistants. So I hope to see you soon in one of the classes, and that's it for now.